So what is model-based systems engineering and why is it important? So what has happened is in the last 15, maybe even earlier, years, the complexity of systems has increased dramatically. And what that means is that we have systems that they have too many components and too many functionalities, and they involve components from different parts of the mechanical, the physical world, and the cyber world. So it's impossible now to design these complex systems to meet various kinds of requirements from simple techniques. So you need a very methodological, systematic way to describe these components, and more importantly, to describe how you're going to put them together. So model-based systems engineering basically arose from this need. And it's capitalized, you know, the advances on information technology that has given us the tools to be able to model complex systems and describe how we'll put them together. And information technology here comes in two ways. One comes because we have little chips or other computer embedded to these mechanical and other components, and the other is because of the computer tools we have. So because of the embedding of these computer systems into all the mechanical components and other things that we have in complex systems, we can sort of translate many of the mechanical, physical, and chemical and other requirements to things that they are more computer-like. And therefore, we can actually argue and synthesize things like that, which are complex. Now, this methodology, it applies to anything from smartphones to medical systems, to hospitals, to airplanes, to automobiles, to basically anything that you would like to call a complex system. And most of the things we manufacture and design today are complex systems. So, for instance, let's take a car, and you want to describe how you're going to design a braking system. So you first have to decide what parts of the car are going to be involved in braking. Is it going to be the pads only? Is it going to be the wheels? Is it going to be the shock absorber? Is it going to be the chassis? Is it going to be the seat of the driver? Is it going to be the driver? Which of these components will be involved in the braking function? How do you describe these components, and what? How do you describe various versions of these components? Because a designer has to have a component, but then different versions of these components. And then there is cyber part, right? There are electronic parts that they can go into the shock absorbers. There are electronic parts that they control the braking function. How do you link these electronic components with the mechanical components in such a way so that you can have what everybody wants, a error-free, smooth braking? That's a very simple problem to understand where model-based system engineering comes in. And you have then some more difficult questions. How much of this braking system is going to be allocated to the mechanical part of the system, or how much you're going to make electronic, and why? And then the sort of the hardest part of model-based systems engineering is how to take requirements that you describe in everyday language, I want to have a comfortable and accurate braking, and translate those to quantitative requirements, things that they can be represented by numbers, by rules, and so on and so forth, and they have to be put into these components. And then, after you finish with design, you have to have a way to automatically validate that what you designed satisfies what you thought in the beginning. So that's the cycle of model-based systems engineering, and it's at the heart of everything that engineering and other parts of technology ought to be today. And as many recent papers have noted and articles, it is the holy grail of engineering. It's the most transformational of engineering today. So we are very much involved in that here in Maryland, and our whole model systems engineering masters is trying to teach this method, and it better say to teach what we understand for the method, because the method itself actually is evolving.